Romeo's description of Juliet's beauty is done. According to the story, the beauty goes on, the description goes on, these two people meet each other for a long time, they meet secretly, and none of us know the actual fact. They even, Romeo and Juliet, they secretly get married with the help of their, you know, father, friend and all those things. They secretly get married, and on the day of marriage, the Juliet is seen here waiting for Romeo. And the words that she says now is her eagerness, eagerly waiting for Juliet, for Romeo to come. We have understood, in the story, it is almost like Romeo coming to Juliet's balcony every night, meeting her secretly, and then going away in the morning. This happens for a long time. But here, the first time when the people are trying to meet after their secret marriage, Juliet is desperate. She wants to see Romeo at any cost. The day of the wedding, the day of their secret marriage, she eagerly waits for him. As I told you, she's desperate for it. Her curiosity, her eagerness, her desperate feeling is shown in this verse. Juliet's verse, she says, "Come, Romeo, come, you are the day in the night." Again, a contrasting word here. The day in the night. It is night time, but still, when you come, you shine brightly and you bring daylight to my life. So she says, "You are the day in my life. The day in night, you come. I'm waiting for you. Just come. You come on the wings of the night." Wings are compared to a black bird. Night is compared to a black bird with large, big wings. And Romeo is imagined to come sitting on this black bird. She says, "Come, you are coming on the wings of the night. You are just like the new snow on the raven's back." The night, when I told you, it is compared to a black bird, it is called as a raven. Raven is a big crow. A crow, the size of the raven is slightly bigger than the normal crow that we see everywhere. So raven's black, you come on that, it is almost like the white snow that can be seen. So when you come here, you just fade away the darkness, you throw away the darkness, and only the brightness of your face, the beauty of your face comes to me, comes to my room. So you are the day in night, and you are the new snow on the raven's back. You come like that beautiful, soothing, cool snow during night time. He also says that night, she also says the night, and she says it is black-browed night. Again, as I told you, in Juliet's verses, there are two or three personifications done. Personification means when a non-living object is compared to a human being and it is given life. Here, night is nothing to do with human beings. It is just an identity. It is just a thing that happens in the nature. But according to poets and their works, the poets, they describe the night or the nature as human beings giving them some life. And that part is called as personification. Here, night is personified. Night is personified, and then it is actually explained to have black, thick eyebrows. Very handsome, very smart, very good looking human being. So you are like the white snow on the raven's back. That night, like that beautiful black-browed night, you come there. She tells, okay, this is the time when I'm eagerly waiting for you. I wait for you. I love you so much. I'm eager to see you. But she further goes ahead and says, what will happen when I die? When I die, I don't know why suddenly Juliet gets the thought of death. She says, no, in case I die, I don't want my Romeo to suffer with the same feelings that he has to be left alone. So she only prays. She prays that once she dies, after her death, Romeo also should be cut into small, tiny stars. She wants to distribute the beauty of Romeo to the whole world. She wants the whole world to appreciate his handsome features. She is not selfish to just experience all the love, all the beauty by herself. She wants to distribute. So she says, once I am dead and gone, once I am dead, let him be cut into small stars, and all these stars should be thrown away into the sky. And this sky is again personified as the face of the heaven. The sky is the face of the heaven. There, Romeo has to be there. All those tiny stars that have to be thrown into the face of heaven, the personified part of the sky, there everybody has to see Romeo and appreciate it. They'll be eagerly waiting for the stars to come out. That is during night time. They want the stars to come so that they all can see Romeo in those small, tiny little shining and twinkling stars. She further says, when everywhere my Romeo is seen, appreciated and loved by the people as tiny little stars, she also is very sure that the people, the whole world, will forget to worship the garish sun. Actually, we worship sun as we consider him as one of the greatest energy-giving factor, energy-giving source. And we worship sun as God. When the whole earth right now, which is worshipping sun god, now after Romeo is cut into stars, everybody will forget worshipping this garish sun. Garish here means very harsh, cruel and burning. The sun burns everybody. The sun gives lot of heat, and sun brings in pain, heat, sweat and all those things. People don't want sun at all. They want the night to come every day. They want Romeo in the form of stars. They will be madly in love. So this is Juliet's expression. She says, when I'm dead and gone, all these things, Romeo and his beauty has to be distributed to the world. So in this verse, Juliet's verse of William Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet, we have understood that she wants Romeo to come back as night, as day in night, as the bright feature in her night. And then again she goes on to even to the verge of killing herself and killing Romeo and also distributing his beauty as stars. Again here, when we come to the answer writing part, there are many important factors. Let us not be confused. Let us not think that Juliet is a sadist. She is not a sadist. She doesn't want to kill Romeo. But her only thought is, her only prayer is, her love has to be appreciated by everybody. She wants the whole world to understand how beautiful her Romeo is, and let the world not misunderstand Juliet's love for Romeo. Let them not feel that Juliet is a fool. As I told you, when you write the answers, you'll have to again concentrate on all these things that have been underlined, that have been marked again. So this is Juliet's verse in Romeo and Juliet.